Hi, I'm Pat Morris, your host for the PM Talk Show. Our telecast is made possible by these fine underwriters, and we thank them very much.
Locally owned and operated by Drs. Wheat and Boobridge, the Animal Care Center in Hammond and Pet Care Center in Ponchatoula have six vets on staff with nearly a century of combined experience. Celebrating our 30th birthday in May, the Animal Care Center has offered a full line of veterinary services, which includes medicine, surgery, grooming, boarding, and 7 days a week emergency services. Our mission is to provide the highest quality of veterinary care in a professional, compassionate manner. The Animal Care Center and Pet Care Center, a commitment to excellence with love and care for your pet.
Welcome again to the PM Talk Show. This is Pat Morris, your host. We are out here on beautiful Miller Lake, and we have a lot of exciting things going on in the Tashpahoa Parish and surrounding areas. And today we have with us Mrs. Debbie Fleming, who is the Executive Director for the Tashpahoa Parish Voluntary Council on Aging. How are you today?
Wonderful, Pat. How
Good.
Are you?
Good. I'm great. I'm great to have you back, and I know the COA has a lot of exciting things going on, and in the transportation area, let's just talk about something exciting that you all are doing now.
Oh yes, thank you so much for inviting me and for having me here today. And transportation is always exciting and fun and irritating and frustrating all at the same time, but it's wonderful. We are providing service to people,
right.
And it's not about, oh, you're doing a wonderful thing. It's about people need transportation to get to shopping, school, appointments, medical appointments, other kinds of appointments. So the Council on Aging is the designated public transit system for Tangipahoa Parish. Parish government is the applicant for the federal and state funding. They have designated the Council on Aging as the provider. We have three pieces to that. The first one is our demand response system. People can call 748-6016 anytime and schedule a ride for demand response, meaning we will come to the house, pick you up at your door, bring you to your appointment. Mm-hmm. People 60 years old and older do not have to pay for that. Their fare is paid by Council on Aging right. funding. Mm-hmm. People under 60 years old can arrange the ride, but they have to pay $9 one way. Okay. That is the cost of providing that service. We are a nonprofit organization. So that is just the cost to provide it. That, and we will Monday through Friday, 8 o'clock in the morning till 4 o'clock in the afternoon is the general service time. Our office hours, our dispatcher answers the phone at 8:30 in the morning, so we need 24 hours notice for the appointment. But we will go anywhere within Tangipahoa Parish. Same cost, $9 one way, unless they're 60 or older, and we ask them for a donation if they are 60 or older, which helps us provide more service. Right. But if they can't pay, that's fine. And that has helped many, many, many people. We bring people into our senior centers, to the doctor's office. We have helped people get to and from work until they can get their own transportation. We also provide, the second piece of it is the city of Hammond in 2007 stepped up and paid the 50% of the cost to operate a bus within the city limits of Hammond. We have bus stops all around Hammond in 1 hour loops. So if you get on at the Social Security office, in an hour that bus will be back, and you can, they can drop you off there. In 1 hour you can get back on and go back to where you originated. And the exciting thing is recently Ponchatoula City Council and the mayor agreed to provide a service in the Ponchatoula city limits. So we are extremely excited about that and grateful to the government for providing that. There are so many people who need the help. Right. And this has just really, we're not quite settled on the route and the timing. We threw something out and tried it, and we found that we need to change it a little bit. So we did publish a route in the Times, and we will have to, in the next few weeks, change that route. The timing's a little bit off. But, it's very difficult to put that together. But it's going well, And I, as far as I know, everybody seems to be happy with it. I haven't heard any major complaints, but it goes all the way to North Oaks. Okay. And the Hammond bus goes to North Oaks. Okay. So if you live in Ponchatoula and you need to go, you want to take classes at Southeastern, mm-hmm. you can get off the Ponchatoula bus and get on the Hammond bus and go to Southeastern.
Okay, that sounds great. How can a person find out where the routes are?
The Hammond route is on our website, www.tangicoa.com, and I'm in the process of putting the Ponchatoula okay. schedule on there. I think I should wait until we yep. change it. Mm-hmm. It has been published in the newspaper, or they can call. Anybody can call us. We can mail the list, or we'll get it to people. We can discuss it with them. A lot of times people will call and say, well, I live over here down this street. What's the closest bus stop? And we will help them figure out where, how far they really would have to walk to get to a bus stop and how close it will take them to their destination.
Right, and that's amazing, because I had a doctor's appointment last week and your bus was there. Uh-huh. And to hear the people talk about that service and how if it were not for the service, they wouldn't be able to get to and from the doctor, that's really amazing.
Yeah.
And I want to compliment you all for doing a
Thank
great
you.
Job and helping the needy.
Thank you. Again, it is about helping the people. And I hope that we do a good job. Of course, we can't do everything that everybody needs. People need things we can't provide. And we just do everything we can to help get everybody what they need.
Now, Northern Tangipahoa Parish, I'm sure you have buses up there as well that go up to Kentwood, or how far north do you go?
Yes, the entire system is parish-wide. Okay. We don't cross parish lines, not that we can't, but in our application for funding, we told them we will stay within Tangipahoa Parish, but we are in negotiations with St. Tammany Parish, and I have a dream, my next dream. My Hammond City bus was a dream, Ponchatoula City bus was a dream. Now, the next dream is coming from Kentwood to at least Independence at Lally Kemp.
Okay.
If we could get something going from Kentwood to Lally Kemp, that would help a lot of people. The problem, right. Mm-hmm. The problem is the funding.
Yeah.
Somebody has to pay the 50%. DOTD, our funding source, pays 50% of the cost to operate.
Okay.
So somebody has to pay the other 50%.
Okay. Well, have you thought about maybe the three municipalities on that end, maybe splitting that cost?
Oh, sure. I know that everybody struggles for funding, and it's a great idea, and the municipalities would love to be able to do it. It's just tough. The budgets are tight.
Yeah. Well, thank you for everything that you're doing to provide the services, and I know you have a lot of other services that you continue to provide for the citizens of Tangipahoa Parish. Can we talk about some of those?
Oh, sure. I love, 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 love the Council on Aging and the services provided to the seniors. The senior centers located in Kentwood, Ameet, Independence, Hammond, and Ponchatoula.
So five.
Five senior centers. So no matter where you live in Tangipahoa Parish, a senior center is close by. The transportation service will pick you up at your door, 60 years old and older, and that's a law, federal law, I didn't make it up, and that will bring you to the senior center. And there, people talk, laugh, play games. We have an art class in Hammond with funding from the Baton Rouge Arts Council. We do exercise class. Of course, they play bingo. They love bingo. So the community is wonderful about providing prizes for bingo. And we just try to have a good time and get people out of their home so they're not at home alone all day. We just bring them in and show them love and have fun with them and listen to them as best we can. And again, we can't help everybody with every need, but we do the best we can. We have a wonderful staff, very little staff turnover, because it's a mission. To most of our employees, it's just a mission, and they do the job so well, and I'm just so proud of them.
Okay, I had a guest a week or so ago on, Ms. Belinda Vining. She's the CEO for Parishes Supportive Living, and when I'm listening to the services that you provide, some of them, I think about some of the things, and something that she said that really struck home is people don't forget about the elderly.
That's right.
Don't forget.
And we think about it in this heat,
yes,
the hot, hot weather, and I remind people, just check. If you have an elderly neighbor or relative, just check on them once in a while. I think as we get older, we tend to not hydrate as much as we should. And of course, that puts people in the hospital, and we don't want that.
Right, right. We want them to be okay. I remember years ago, the Council on Aging, and that's when things weren't as tight with money as they are now, but
yeah,
the Council on Aging would donate small air conditioners or small fans to people. Are you still doing some of that type of thing?
Sure,
now?
We do. We have a program. It's called Helping Hands through Entergy. Entergy employees donate money and Entergy matches it. So that goes dollar for dollar to help the elderly pay their utility bills if they need it. They have to have an emergency, like unusual medical expenses or something, the washing machine broke down and they have to get it repaired. And with that funding, they allowed me to buy fans, heaters, air conditioners, electric blankets. For a while it was just fans,
yeah,
and I went into some homes with the windows all boarded up, and the fan just stirred up the hot air.
Yeah.
So I asked Entergy if they could allow me to buy small window units, mm-hmm, so that the elderly could get some relief, mm-hmm, from the heat and a good night's sleep. So that's worked out really well, and we have a foundation who has made some donations, mm-hmm, towards those air conditioners.
And I'm sure you have your guidelines set for people who will qualify.
Yes, and recently, actually right now, we are in a transition period. The Entergy has a contract with the Salvation Army now,
okay,
to do this service. So the Council on Aging will continue, will begin again in October, submitting applications to the Salvation Army, and then they will pay the bill.
Right.
Or decide if the person's bill can be paid through this program.
Oh, wow, that's
so
great.
So it's still there, but it is changing.
Mm-hmm. And it's great to see so much collaborating going on between,
yeah,
various agencies, because I feel this way the dollar would go a lot farther if you do that.
I agree. We get so much bang for the buck, as they,
right,
say. We can make that penny just stretch so much further when the community's involved, and we are in such a wonderful community. Tangipahoa Parish is so giving and generous and kind and just wonderful, wonderful people, and I'm honored to be serving the elderly in Tangipahoa Parish.
Great. Well, we're going to go for a break right now, and when we come back, we'll come back with part two on some more of the exciting things that are going on with the Tangipahoa Voluntary Council on Aging. We're going for a break, and we'll be right back.
At shelters, you'll discover healthy and loving animals just waiting to become a part of your family. Why wait? You can make a difference in the life of an animal. A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. Be that person and adopt your new best friend today. To find out more, visit theshelterpetproject.org.
Welcome back to the PM Talk Show. This is Pat Marsh, your host. We have with us a very special guest, Mrs. Debbie Flemings, who is the Executive Director for the Tangipahoa Parish Voluntary Council on Aging. Ms. Flemings, before we went to break, we were talking about the services, the transportation, and all of the good things that the Council on Aging is doing for the elderly. Your transportation service is simply phenomenal, and we're glad to see that. But we have two more things that are getting ready to happen now. Do you want to share any of that with us?
The first thing I would like to mention to everybody is the open enrollment for, like, Medicare Part D. That's
right,
the prescription drug plans that so many people struggle trying to figure out what's the best plan for me.
Right.
So the Council on Aging is working with the Department of Insurance, Senior Health Insurance Information Program, we call it SHIP. we are planning some events where we can help people fill out an application online just to compare what they have with what's available and make sure that what they have is still the best option for them, because things do change in the year. I guess that's why there is an open enrollment, so that we can look at all of their Medicare and their prescription drugs and whatever else they would like for us to look at. And what we're talking about doing with the Department of Insurance, some of the senior centers don't have internet. If anybody wants to pay for internet for Kentwood and Independence, we'll take it. But the what we can do is take the application at the senior centers and then go to a computer that does have the internet, like our Hammond Center, and enter that information and print out the options for the individuals. So we're planning to set up probably two events a month, because there are 20,000 people in Tangipahoa Parish eligible for this Medicare program, and we want to make sure that everybody has the information they need mm-hmm. to make the best decision for their particular situation.
Right. And the other thing?
The other thing that's coming up in November, there will be on the election, on the ballot, Amendment number 11 is making room for the Department of Elderly Affairs that was created by our legislature last year. So the department has been created, but Louisiana can only have 20 departments, and we have 20 departments, 20 wonderful, valuable departments. But in order to make room for our Department of Elderly Affairs, the voters, the legislature approved this year for the voters to decide if we want 21 departments. It won't cost the state anymore. Nothing changes. It just comes from the Office of Elderly Affairs becomes the Department of Elderly Affairs. It's already in existence. It just becomes a department, which will help more people.
Mm-hmm. Okay, when I look at your mission statement, it means in essence you're going to provide services for people 60 and over to allow them to remain in their homes for as long as possible. Yeah. One of those services is your homemaker service.
Right. We want to help people stay at their home. We had a director of the state office one time talk about going into a nursing home and seeing somebody who was very active, and he said, "Why are you here?" And she said, "Well, my last light bulb burned out in my house and I couldn't change it, so I decided to come live in the nursing home." And she was very happy, and it was a great place for her. But the homemaker service and little things like changing a light bulb, our homemaker service will help people with their sheets. You know, when I have trouble changing my sheets, lifting that mattress to change it, and vacuuming and mopping. So we have a small program. Of course, there's not a lot of money in it, and there is a waiting list. But the idea is that we will help people keep their bathrooms clean, their sheets clean, just enough to keep them clean at their home so they don't get any kind of disease or illness, but they can stay in their home a little bit longer and be independent.
Okay, when you look at your exercise program, that's another service that you give to people. What is FAST? What that acronym, what does that stand for?
Oh, FAST was, actually I need to update that. We try to help them with exercises for arthritis. Okay. And we were trained, our staff was trained by the Arthritis Association for those exercises, because we don't want to hurt anybody. We don't want to encourage them to exercise in a way that might do them more harm than good. So in the beginning, we had a physical therapist even come talk to our staff to make sure that we weren't trying to get them to do something they shouldn't. But each one of the sites has its own little exercise class. Some use the bands and the weights, and some move faster than others. Ponchatoula has a wonderful exercise class in the gym. We're at the community center in Ponchatoula, and those ladies are just hard to keep up with. I tried to exercise with them once and they wore me out. They are just wonderful. Hammond has a regular class. The other three smaller sites have smaller classes, but you know, if you can't stand, you can hold on to a chair. Okay. And so the exercises fit what the individual needs.
Right, and I'm sure they enjoy all of that, too.
Yes.
Yeah. Your emergency response units, what is that?
We have, in cooperation and partnership with Acadian,
okay,
on call, mm-hmm, if somebody needs, it's that medical alert button,
okay,
that you wear around your neck,
okay,
or one lady wanted it on her wrist because, mm-hmm, it didn't match her outfit. So you push that button if you fall or have some other emergency, and it will dispatch the ambulance, the fire department, the emergency responders will come and help you out. And it's $22, I believe, if you go through the Council on Aging. If you go directly to Acadian, I think it's more like $35, $40. And they've come out with a new one that's more like a cell phone kind of operation. The $22 one does require a telephone line in your home that this just plugs into it, and you can go outside and work in your yard, and if you happen to fall or get too hot, you can push the button and it will call help for you.
And those devices are purchased by the people themselves, right?
Yes. They call the Council on Aging. We do an application. We send that to Acadian, and then it's between the individual and Acadian.
Okay. When you look at your assessment and screening process for your services, how does that operate?
If somebody called us, like your neighbor, you might be concerned about your neighbor. You may call us and say, I don't know what she needs, I don't really know her business, but I think she might need some help. And I asked her if I could call you and if you would come and see her. We will go into the home and talk to the individual and see if there are any services that we provide or know about. Even if we don't provide it, we have a lot of resources and know what other services are available. And we will set them up, give them the phone numbers, but we go into the home and we do an assessment of their needs.
Okay. When you look at your congregate meals, I know that's coming through the sites. What type of success stories can you share?
So many people tell me over and over, I just don't know what I would do without your meals. I would not be here today if it weren't for this senior center and the congregate meals. They are hot, well-balanced meals, mm-hmm, served Monday through Friday, mm-hmm, in 5 locations. Mm-hmm. The meals are actually cooked in Baton Rouge. We're part of a 10-parish district, so, mm-hmm, that it's cheaper, mm-hmm, like buying in bulk. And they are brought to the senior centers. We put them on steam tables. The staff is trained to test the temperature and make, mm-hmm, sure that they're safe. And we serve that lunch. And many people, that's the only meal, well-balanced, mm-hmm, hot meal they get. Mm-hmm. So they tell us over and over how valuable it is and how,
yeah,
it has saved their lives.
Oh, and it just warms your heart to know that it's available.
Yes.
You know. When you look at the Capital Area Agency on Aging, I'm sure all Councils on Aging fall under that umbrella?
That is the 10 parish district.
Okay.
Capital Area Agency on Aging serves 10 parishes. There is a SINLAW in Central Louisiana Area Agency on Aging and Cajun.
Okay.
So those are the 3 area agencies, and they're more district offices, so that the state and federal money goes directly to that district office, and they hire the dietitian and, you know, a lot of things that we can't afford to do.
Mm-hmm. Okay, when I look at your slogan, growing older, growing better.
Oh, yeah.
Explain that a little bit.
Oh, my goodness. I just talking to our seniors and being around them makes me feel happier, healthier. They just get better with age. They're wise and wonderful and just a blessing to me. And they tell us all the time how blessed they are no matter what their circumstances. You will run across people who are just like, life is good.
Right.
And that's growing better.
Mm-hmm. Let me ask you this, referencing our school system, do any of your seniors go into the schools maybe to read to the kids or talk to them from time to time, those that are able to do so?
If they do, that is not really something the Council on Aging coordinates. Okay. We hear them talk about doing those things, and we could provide transportation to get them there if they want to do that. We would be happy to work with them. If that's something they want to do, we'll try to figure out some way to help them do that.
Okay.
Because that's just so fun.
Yeah.
And such an asset to the school.
Yeah, and I can imagine the faces of the small children, especially when they're being read to.
Yes.
And, you know, just say retired teachers who come to the center,
right.
It would be such an asset.
Oh,
to
it's
do
like
that.
Grandma reading you a story.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
just,
of course.
Yeah, it's
yeah.
great.
Okay, well, we're getting towards the end of our program. Do you have any closing comments?
I, again, want to thank my staff, because the people who work at the Council on Aging are the Council on Aging.
Right.
And the ladies who deliver the meals to the homebound, for example,
yeah.
when they wake up in the morning, if they don't feel really well, we might say, oh, I don't feel like going to work today. But if they don't work, people don't eat.
Right.
So they get up and they go to work, and before they know it, they feel a whole lot better.
Great.
And one of them started wearing crazy socks.
Okay.
So that when she walks into the house, it draws a smile, like, mm-hmm. oh my goodness, what kind of socks do you have on today?
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Cheer them up.
Right, right. Well, we want to thank you for joining us again. And of course, our doors are always open to you for whatever you want to talk about and let the people know. Thank you for joining us again. And this is Pat Marsh, your host, saying that we thank you for continuing to join us. We know that knowledge is powerful and it does matter. Please enjoy your week. Thank you and God bless. Mm-hmm.